Good Monday, everybody. Jewel here with the J7409 Weather Channel, hoping everybody has a wonderful, great day today. But we do have a significant icing event that's going to take place. Before we get to that, let's check out what today's high temperatures are going to look like. You can see we got that cold air moving in, our friends up in Canada. Ooh-wee, zero for a high today. Look at that right there. Over here, we got another zero. Over in Maine, looking like mostly 20s, maybe teens in the northern sections as we move down the coastline. You can see it's beginning to get a little colder feeling. Eastern North Carolina, moving on down into Florida. We're going to be okay today. We'll be in the 50s. That's a far cry from what a lot of the other folks and our friends across the nation are having. But by Friday, look out, it's going to start to get colder. We're going to feel the pinch. But you know where you live on the map, you see what it's looking like. So far as nighttime lows tonight, this is what it's looking like. Okay, up in North Dakota, -4. Minnesota, northern Minnesota, -9. You see these temperatures, we come on over into Oklahoma, you should be down in the low 20s. Now, everybody over here, you're a little bit warmer right now, and your temperatures from, say, Washington State, Oregon, Northern California, you guys should start to warm up just a little bit, maybe by tomorrow or Wednesday. Other than that, this is what the temperatures are looking like. And I want to thank everybody for joining me now. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking all this out with me. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, the whole nine yards. I would appreciate it very, very much. Here we have the NDFD map. Folks, I've checked out the Euro, I've checked out the GFS, I've checked out so many models, and it does look like this ice is going to happen and create a lot of hazardous travel, plus power outages for people. So keep that in the back of your head. Make sure you have a way to stay warm, have some light, and have you something to eat, because the ice is going to happen. Now, this map is going to take us through this afternoon and all of the runs through Tuesday and Wednesday at 12 noon. So I'll let it loop around. Before I do that, though, where you see this orange, this is going to be the ice. This is going to be the ice. And when you see these little hatch marks, it could be even more in the way of this happening for you, okay? Of course, the blue is snow and the green is rain. So let's just get going. I'm going to let it loop through, because this strong Arctic cold front, folks, it has progressed through the Great Plains, and it's going to set the stage for an impactful winter weather event throughout the Southern Plains and the Mid-South. Now, as the precipitation overruns a frontal boundary, as you can see, it's going to push north into a cold air mass that's in place over the surface for the next several days. Now, this freezing rain and sleet is likely to be the main precipitation type beginning today in the form of freezing drizzle, with the weather pattern expecting to remain in place through at least Wednesday, maybe even Thursday. We'll have to wait and see how fast this thing moves. Several rounds of wintry weather may lead to icy conditions from Texas to Tennessee. Now, as a result, sleet and freezing rain accumulations look like they're going to be widespread hazardous travel, as I've said, for several days in a row, especially if you're on an untreated surface. Now, ice accretion is anticipated to impact a large geographical region, with light amounts spanning over at least 15 states. That's right, you heard me right. Ice can happen to accumulate over at least 15 states. Now, total freezing rain amounts could become significant across parts of central Texas, southwest Oklahoma, central Arkansas, and western Tennessee, where over a quarter of an inch of ice is expected to accumulate. Now, I've named these areas, but surrounding areas around these places, I said southwest Oklahoma, northeast Oklahoma, you could have some too, just not as much. But it's looking like the significant ice is going to be probably in parts of central Texas, southwest Oklahoma, central Arkansas, and western Tennessee. Now, we have a low that's going to moderate the chances for 3 days of ice accumulations over a half an inch. That exists over parts of central Texas and Arkansas. And in addition, this potentially hazardous travel condition is going to stay with everybody, and the amount of ice can lead to scattered tree damage, power outages, sleet up to a half an inch is possible. Far northern sections of the precipitation from northern Texas to northern Arkansas. And that can lead to very slippery conditions and very bad travel conditions. Now we've got the temperatures to look at. We got this cold air mass, and that's going to be responsible for the icy forecast in the Mid-South, and it's also going to lead to a frigid start to this week throughout the remainder of the central U.S. and into western states. Now, looking like right now, temperatures 20, 30 degrees below average will support single-digit high temperatures from the central high plains to the upper Midwest today, with lows starting out well below zero for tonight. Now, gusty winds, that's going to create these dangerous wind chills. I'm talking dangerous wind chills. Many, many wind chill watches and warnings are up. Please go check out the community page. Now, wind chills as low as 55 degrees below zero in the northern plains. That's what's going to happen. Wind chill warnings and advisories have been issued to further highlight the extreme cold threat, and it's going to span from Oregon to Wisconsin. Fortunately, the bitter cold air mass looks like it will gradually warm starting midweek in these places that I showed you out west. Now, by Wednesday, we're going to have another influx of moisture over eastern Texas, and that's going to lead to heavy rain and flash flooding concerns. Now, we need to be aware of this. As of today, we have no severe weather to look at so far as tornadoes, high downdraft winds or hail. That's all looking good. Now, we got a closed upper level low. It's going to drop south today off the coast of Southern California. That's going to help funnel moisture into the southwest and central Rockies. Periods of heavy snow are possible over the higher terrain of western Colorado as well as Southern California mountain areas. And your travel could be difficult at times for the mountain passes. Now, farther east, lake effect snow is likely downwind of the Great Lakes for today, with the heaviest amounts over 6 inches possible. That's going to be off of Lake Superior and Lake Erie. Otherwise, periods of light snow are possible throughout the interior northeast and mid-Atlantic as this cold front is going to push on through tomorrow. Folks, don't take this ice event too lightly, because it could cause a whole lot of trouble for a whole lot of people, especially in Texas. Texas, as it moves on across, please be aware. Check out the watches and warnings. I have an example here. This is for Memphis and western Tennessee. Now, this is today. This is your wind chill. This is the blue line. Your regular temperatures are up in here, looking like you'll be in the mid-30s maybe, or lower 30s. Your winds are going to pick up some with the storm as it moves across. Now, right here, we have a little bit of rain. But as we move down, look at this. Starting tonight, the freezing rain is going to start. Then, in the early morning hours around 2 a.m. through 5 a.m., more freezing rain with sleet on top of it. Should get a little bit of break from the freezing rain in the morning tomorrow morning between 8 and 11, but in that time period, you still have a chance of sleet falling. Now, it's going to pick back up again, as you can see, tomorrow, say around lunchtime or a little bit after. You are going to have, as you can see right here, a 60 to 70% chance of freezing rain and a 60 to 70% chance of sleet. And that's going to go right on through lunch, start around lunchtime tomorrow, go right on through midnight and 2 a.m. and 5 a.m. for Wednesday morning. So please don't take this so lightly. If you have anything you have to do, if you don't have to go out in it, don't go out in it. And like I say, I can't put everything up here. This is just one example for Memphis and Western Tennessee. Other places, like I've talked about, please go over, check out the community page for everything I've got up there. Texas, you're in a big swath of it. It's going to move right on across for the next few days, all the way up to portions of West Virginia. Now, it could change slightly, so be sure and tune in tomorrow. I'll give you my latest forecast. Thanks so much for watching. I love you all so much. Please stay safe. Please stay warm. And once again, if you don't have to go out where this ice is going to accumulate, don't do it. Stay in. Make sure you got a way to have heat. Make sure you got a way to eat. Make sure that everything is taken care of, because this ice is going to happen. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. I love you so much. Thank you for sharing my videos, just watching my videos. But this is important, folks. Please share this video to help me keep people aware and safe of what's going to be coming up and what's going to happen. Okay? People might get caught off guard. They don't need to be out in it unless it is an extreme emergency. Don't go out in this ice. Thank you so much for your donations. Just everything you do for me. I love you all so much. And may each of you have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.